Welcome back. Now we are going to perform experiment number 5, which is on single phase transformer. And what are the objective? We want to see the efficiency and regulation of a single phase transformer. And to do that, we are going to perform two tests on single phase transformer. One is open circuit test and the other one is short circuit test. Now, all of us know that there are mainly two types of losses in a transformer. One is the copper loss and another is the core loss. So this short circuit test you can perform to get those copper loss, which is mainly occurring in the winding, and the open circuit test you can perform to get core loss, which is occurring in the core of the transformer, and it has mainly two types. One is this hysteresis loss and the other one is the eddy current loss. So by short circuit test we are getting some loss and open circuit test we are getting some other loss. But these two tests we are not performing at the same time. So we are not getting the total loss of the transformer at any given point of time. So can you suggest a test which we can use to get total power loss in a transformer? So which should have all the information about core loss as well as copper loss, which is not possible when you do individually short circuit and open circuit test. So those who are familiar with this, please mention about that test in the comment section. So now when there is some losses inside this transformer, due to those losses there will be heat generated inside this transformer and its temperature will build up. So higher the losses, higher will be the temperature. Now the rating of transformer is done such a way that it can operate at that condition for a long time without overheating the transformer. So this is very important to note, and that's why we were interested to get all this loss information. Now before moving to the actual experiment, let us try to first see what is the inside view of a transformer that we are going to use in our experiment. So as you can see, this transformer, this is the core part, and you can see lot of those lamination present here, and this is the winding part. And if you look at this structure, so we have one limb here, another limb will be there in the middle, and this one is another limb. So this structure is basically a shell type transformer. And now we are going to perform the open circuit test, and for performing this open circuit test we are using a single phase transformer over here. So this is the transformer on which we are going to perform this open circuit test, and also we are going to perform the short circuit test on the same transformer. And how it is connected? So it has one side rated for 220 volt and the other side it has two windings, two output. We are going to take only one of the output. So we are calling it high voltage side, and this side we are calling it low voltage side. And if you look at this low voltage arrangement, so this is the common terminal. Between these two terminal we have 110 volt rating, and between these two we have rating of 86%, and between these two we have rating of 50%, and this set of terminals are for the second output that we are not going to use. Primary side current of a transformer has two components. One is the magnetizing component and second one is the load component. Now in open circuit test, the secondary side is going to be open circuited, so there is no load current. So the primary current will be constituting only the magnetizing current part. And as a result, the power factor at the primary side will be very low. And to measure power on the primary side, we need an wattmeter which can give us accurate power at low power factor. There are two generic type of wattmeter available here. We have one low power factor wattmeter and one high power factor wattmeter. So for open circuit test, we are going to use low power factor wattmeter because on the primary side, power factor is going to be low. But if you take the case of short circuit test, there the secondary side is going to be short circuited and rated current will flow on the secondary side. So that will get reflected on the primary side, and the load component will be dominating here. It will be much higher than the magnetizing component of current, and as a result power factor will be high at the short circuit test. So there we will be using an wattmeter which is a high power factor wattmeter. Now to perform the open circuit test, we have to open circuit one of the side and we have to connect our power supply to the other side. Now the question is which side we are going to open. So you can see there are two sides, this HV side and LV side. HV stands for high voltage side. So now if we want to perform this test on the high voltage side, we have to connect a power supply rated for 220 volt, and we have to use a voltmeter which is also rated for 220 volt. But if you want to perform the open circuit test on the LV side, we need a power supply of only 110 volt, and the voltmeter that we have to connect this side is also we require at 110 volt. So the rating of instrument will be less if we perform the open circuit test, we connect the power supply on the low voltage side and if we keep the high voltage side open. Now let's try to understand the circuit arrangement that we need for performing open circuit test. So we need to apply a voltage across this primary side which have maximum value of 110 volt. Now the power supply we have at our lab is 230 volt, so we cannot give 230 volt directly to the primary side because it will be more than its rated magnitude and it will destroy the transformer. So what we are using, an auto transformer to reduce the voltage so that we can give a maximum of 110 volt. We'll be taking some reading at reduced voltage also, but the maximum voltage that we are going to apply is 110 volt, and that is the reason that we need a auto transformer. And now let's see how to make the connections. So first there is a variac or auto transformer, and from this auto transformer we are taking connection to the DPST. And from the other side of the DPST, we will connect an ammeter. So as you can see here, this wire is coming to ammeter, and from the ammeter other terminal, we are connecting it to the M terminal of the wattmeter. And then this M and C terminal, they are shorted, and from the L terminal, we are connecting to the transformer. And if we look at the circuit diagram, from the low voltage side other terminal, so there it will go to voltmeter one terminal goes to the wattmeter V terminal, and the remaining one goes to the supply. So basically from this side of the transformer we'll have three wires. So let's see. So from this terminal of the transformer we have three wires. One of them is going to the wattmeter, this one is going to the wattmeter, and then other two, one of them will be going to a voltmeter. So this wire is going back to the supply, and the third one is going to voltmeter, this one. So this ammeter is connected in series with the primary. This voltmeter is connected across the primary or the low voltage side. And there is a second voltmeter that we are connecting to the secondary side. And how we are connecting? So these are the two terminal, and these are taken to the secondary side of the transformer, which is 220 volt side. So this is how the connection is made. And now we'll be applying voltage, and we are going to note down one set of readings. Now before noting down the readings, we have to observe carefully what is the multiplying factor for this special wattmeter. So here as you can see, it is a low power factor wattmeter, and it is clearly mentioned that cos phi, the power factor is rated for 0.2. So how do you calculate multiplying factor for such wattmeter? It is the voltage range that you are using and current range that you are using into this number. So this is VI cos phi. So this total number divided by the full scale reading, that will give you the multiplying factor. So let's take an example. We are connecting the voltage terminal at 150 volt range, and this connection, as you know, this is for series connection. Two coils are connected in series, so this is for 2.5. So 2.5 into 150 into 0.2, that is around 75, and 75 by 40, so the nearest integer is 2. So this is the reason that multiplying factor for this arrangement will be 2. So let's cross check it. We are using 2.5 here and we have 150 volts selected, so the multiplying factor is 2. Now we are turning on the power supply, and then we will start taking the reading. So we are turning on this 230 volt power supply, which is taken to the auto transformer, and we have made sure that the auto transformer is at zero dial now. And now we'll turn on the DPST, and then we'll increase the auto transformer voltage to 110 volt. So we are just taking only one reading. You can take 3-4 readings. And why we are restricting it to 110 volt? Because that is the rated voltage of the transformer that we are testing. So in no case we should exceed 110 volt. Okay, so we have provided around 110 volt, and we are going to take one set of readings. Now let's try to see the circuit arrangement for this short circuit test. And this is the transformer on which we are going to perform this test. And as you can see, the power supply is connected to the high voltage side, and on the low voltage side we are short circuiting through an ammeter. As we know, ammeter has very low internal resistance. So basically connecting an ammeter means we are short circuiting the secondary side. Now the question is, why we are short circuiting the low voltage side and why we are giving supply to the high voltage side? So one of the key reason for this is that during short circuit test we want to have rated current flowing through the transformer. So whatever supply we are connecting, this must have the capability to provide us the rated amount of current. Now let's try to understand this ratings. So the transformer that we are using is a 3 kVA transformer, and the primary side rated voltage is 110 volt. So primary side rated current will be this 3000, which is 3 kVA by 110, that is 27.2 ampere. And on the secondary side, which is high voltage side, we have 220 volt rating. So secondary side current is, rated current is 13.6 ampere. So now if we perform the short circuit test by connecting power supply to the primary side, so that power supply must have capability to give us 27.2 ampere of current. And if we connect it on the secondary side, if the power supply has 13.6 ampere of current, that should be sufficient. So this is the reason that we are connecting power supply to the high voltage side, because high voltage side rated current is less. And how much voltage we have to apply to the high voltage side? Typically that is very low voltage we have to apply, because secondary side is short circuited. So even though it is actually high voltage side, you will see that even if we apply very less amount of voltage, maybe in the order of 10 to 20 volt, the rated current will start flowing. So that is why we cannot give 230 volt directly here. So again we are using an auto transformer to reduce the voltage, and then we are giving it to the high voltage side so that we can restrict our current within that rated value, which is 13.6 ampere on the high voltage side. So after the auto transformer, as usual we are connecting a DPST, then this ammeter, then this wattmeter. Now observe, here we are using an unity power factor wattmeter, because in short circuit test the primary side current will be both magnetizing current plus the load current, and since we are applying rated load current, so basically the primary current will be dominated by the load current and you will get high power factor. And on the high voltage side we are also connecting this voltmeter to measure the voltage across high voltage side. So let us see first how to make connection, and then we will take one set of reading. So we have this auto transformer and it is connected to the DPST, and other side of the DPST we are connecting it to the ammeter, and other side of the ammeter this is going to the wattmeter M terminal, and M and C are shorted, and from the L terminal of the wattmeter we are connecting to the HV side here, and from the other side of the wattmeter we have connected to two wires. One is going to the power supply side and one more is going to the voltage V terminal of the wattmeter, and this one is going to the voltmeter. So basically these two terminal, these are connected to this voltmeter. And what we are doing on the secondary side, so secondary side will be shorted through an ammeter. So as you can see, this is the secondary side. So this is one terminal and this is the 110 volt terminal. So this one terminal here we are taking it to an emitter through this wire, and through this emitter 30 ampere terminal range we are taking it back here. So basically the secondary side or the low voltage side is short circuited through an emitter, and these two instruments are connected additionally. These are not there in your circuit diagram. So we are connecting a multimeter in the voltmeter mode to measure or to see the primary side or the supply voltage, and one clamp meter which is measuring the primary side current. So these two will be looking very carefully. So we'll be applying voltage slowly such that the primary side current never exceed the rated value. And what is the rated value? It is 13.6 ampere. So we'll slowly now apply voltage. So first we are turning on the power supply for the auto transformer. When we have made sure that the auto transformer is at zero dial, so by mistake also we are not applying any high voltage, then DPHT is closed, and now we will be slowly increasing the voltage and we will keep an eye on the current value. So as you can see, current is increasing, so we are increasing the voltage slowly and we will stop at around 13.5 or 13.6 ampere. And what you can observe here is that what is the voltage we have applied? It is around 12 volt. So even though the rated voltage on the HV side was 220 volt, we are applying just around 12 volt and we are getting the rated current in the primary side. So it has slightly increased because our supply voltage might have increased. So we will reduce the voltage slightly and we will get back to around 13. So one important point here you can observe is that the supply voltage that we assume that it will be always 230 volt constant, that is not the case. It keeps on fluctuating little bit, and as a result these readings will fluctuate minutely, so that you can take care during your reading, or if this variation is very minute you need not note down. Since 13.6 we are seeing that it is exceeding sometime, we will just take a reading at 13 ampere. So we are reducing the current to 13 ampere, so even if there is some fluctuation it is not going to increase. So now let's complete one set of reading. So from this clamp meter and this multimeter we are going to get primary voltage and primary current. You can also get this primary voltage and primary current from this ammeter and voltmeter, so you can take either of them. And what is the wattmeter reading? This wattmeter is having a multiplying factor of 2, so we are going to read what is the value here. It is around 50. So 50 into 2, it is almost 100 watt. And what is the secondary side current? The secondary side current is, we have connected it to 30 ampere scale, so we will be reading that upper scale, and it is around 25 ampere. It is deflecting because our supply voltage is slightly fluctuating as at this point. So you can take roughly that current to be around 25 ampere. And what is the primary side current? It is 12.5. So we have taken a reading at the rated current, and you can take few more readings. So it is mentioned in the procedure. You can take reading at 25%, 50%, 75% of the rated current, and then you can tabulate all those results in this observation table, and you can do calculations for getting those efficiency, regulation, etc. And that is how you can complete this experiment.